If you have tried your hand on the if function in the Excel by going through the task sheet, then let's understand that how to proceed with it. Now this exercise has been created for self understanding the depth in which the if command can be implemented in advanced Excel usage or application. Now here first you have to read the instruction, which clearly states that in the cell G9 and H9 you have to use the if formula. Now in G9 the formula should be that logical test is that technical bit should be between 0 to 8, that is it should be less or equal to 8. Now this is the logical test. Now if the condition is true, the output should be rejected, and if the condition is false, then the output should be blank. Now in this way you have to implement the if formula on the G9 cell. Now similarly you have to implement the if formula on the H9 cell, which clearly states that the logical test, which is technical bit greater than 8, that is 9 or 10, if it's true, then the output must be approved. And if the condition of technical bit score fails, then the output should be blank. So now since we have implemented the formula, we have to use this formula for all the 100 contractors to get that how many contractors are approved. So we will simply drag this formula downward. Since we are not shifting any column, the dollar sign is not required. When we drag it downward, we will get the number of approved contractor. Now if we go to the result status, we can see that our output is correct and the number of total approved contractor are 19, which is correct. So in this way we have correctly implemented the if command. Now let us implement the if and command. The if and command is used when we have multiple logical connections or conditions based on which our output is derived. Again, our input is technical bit. With that, one more input is added, that is contracting experience. Now in this cell H10, we have to use the if and formula. Now since there is only single condition, we will use the if formula. The logical test is that the score should be greater or equal to 5. The score should be lesser or equal to 5. And if the condition is true, then the contractor will be rejected. So if score is less than 5, the contractor will be rejected. Otherwise, leave it blank. So since score is less than 5, we are getting output as rejected. Now here we need to focus. Now we will be using the if and formula since we have two conditions. First is the technical bit score and second is the contracting experience. Now we will use if and then we will use and command. Now the first logic is that our technical score should be greater than 8, and the second condition is that our contracting experience should be greater than 5. So Excel itself guiding us that how we need to type the formula and what values we need to enter. If both the condition match, then we will put the output for the value if true. If both the conditions are not met, then we will put the output for the condition if false. So we'll put approved and rejected. Now we will drag this formula downward so that we can get this desired output for all the 100 contractors. Again, we are not shifting any column, so dollar sign is not required. Now you can see we are getting the approved contractor, which is 14 numbers. So out of this 100 list of contractors, within 10 seconds we can get that how many contractors are approved. We will further understand the more advanced application of the if and command while creating the project management system, which will be equivalent to Primavera or MSP. And the objective of creating it will be to implement the if commands and various other commands in all possible ways. So in this way, we are just clearing our basics that how to use these commands. But again, this simple if command, when used in the advanced Excel, it can bring out the exceptional results. Now this is a simple MIS we have created, in which we are getting a schedule, we are getting the resources, we are assigning the resources, we are getting the daily resource requirement. All this data will be dynamic in nature. That means only the DPR you have to enter, based on which everything will be self-calculated, as we do in MSP or Primavera. Excel is a very, very powerful tool, and through these sessions and training we will understand that how it can be implemented for large data analysis, because Excel provide you the option to customize it. So we will create a management information system which you can utilize it for your project, or you can modify it as per your requirement.